Hi, I'm Shiv. Thanks for checking out our Raise the Line interview series, in which me and my co-host, Osmosis Chief Medical Officer Dr. Rishi Desai, explore how to strengthen our healthcare system with some amazing leaders in medicine, technology, education, and government. And they have some great advice for people starting careers in healthcare as well. I hope you'll watch these highlights and then go listen to the full podcast interview wherever you get your podcasts. Hi, I'm Shiv Gaglani, and today on Raise the Line, I'm happy to be joined by Dr. Michael Sherling, who's the co-founder and chief medical and strategy officer at Modernizing Medicine, which provides specialty specific electronic health record technology to thousands of providers. So how'd you get interested in medicine, then dermatology, and then wind up starting a company?
Yeah, I'm kind of like a dermatologist turned into entrepreneur by circumstance. I had a traditional route to medicine. My father's a pulmonologist. He used to take me and my brother when we were about 5 years old to the hospital with him when he was on call. And he loves what he does and really pushed us to explore a path to helping people. So I went to Yale Medical School in Connecticut. While there at med school, you're allowed to audit classes outside of medicine. So I picked one called How to Start a High-Tech Company. And it was taught by a former venture capitalist who helped fund a company called Pyxis, which is what nurses use to dispense opioid medication. And in the course, he commented on how the best startups form from people in the trenches working to solve problems that fill an unmet need. So fast forward, I enrolled in business school at the time, matched in dermatology residency, and found myself in private practice in South Florida trying to solve a real life problem, how to make electronic health records fast, how to save doctors time. And one of my patients at the time was a 33-year-old software entrepreneur who was in between his companies, Dan Kane. He co-founded a company called Blackboard, an e-learning company that he took public on the NASDAQ for $1.6 billion. And Dan's sitting in my exam room with his robe on, and I'm trying to meet the moment. But first, I have to get through the skin exam and find a way to transition from his exam to a business conversation and then invite him to lunch. And so that's all kind of going through my brain right then. And finally, I take him to his favorite restaurant, John G's, which is beautiful. It's like on the coast of the Atlantic Ocean, and literally draw out the first design for our electronic record system on a napkin. And I tell him we can build a company together and doctors will switch systems for something that's easier to use and faster to document. And being superstitious, I told him that we couldn't go back to the restaurant until we took our yet to form company public. So it's been 10 years, 800 employees, 16,000 providers. And we still haven't eaten there, and he's kind of annoyed at me for that.
If you were going back to day one of medical school at Yale, what is advice that you'd hope someone would tell you about the current moment?
Yeah, I mean, keep an open eye and have patience. It is a longer journey from medical school and residency to, you know, being a fully fledged doctor that compared to other professions. So you may see like your colleagues from college going right in and, you know, making bigger bucks while you're slaving away at night on call. But it's that journey that you will see incredible inefficiencies and opportunities and in the system that only you are uniquely suited to solve. So remember what these opportunities and inefficiencies are. Put yourself in your customer's shoes and solve them. And that's really what makes the world a better place, is physician leaders and them solving them.
Thanks for watching this preview of Raise the Line. To hear the full interview, check out all of our podcasts and subscribe to the series, please go to osmosis.org/Raise the Line podcast or listen wherever you get your podcasts.